last few days. We've had people on who helped me. My dog ran out. I got locked out. A guy came by and he helped me and let me sit in his chair. And then the neighbor took me in and gave me socks. And then the final part of the story is that someone found our dog. Our dog Roxy, there's a little photo of Roxy, put that back up. Roxy is a puppy, she's a Pomeranian puppy. She was out running and the person who found the dog is here and I wanted to talk to him. So please come on out now. Thank you very much for finding our dog.
Oh, no problem at all.
Now, when I phoned you, Michelle made me phone you. Mm-hmm. She said, call this guy and thank him for finding the dog.
Yes.
So I called you and I said, hi, this is Rosie O'Donnell. And then there was dead silence on the phone for a good 40 seconds. Yes. Did you think there was somebody fooling around?
Yes.
You did?
Yeah, because I thought, I left my number with the vet and I thought somebody was just playing with me over there.
Yeah.
And then you said, oh, you're the one who found my dog.
And then you realized it was true.
Yeah.
Okay, so how did you find Roxy?
I was coming back getting the oil changed, and I saw this little animal right out of the corner of my eye. I pulled a car over and had another lady help me about 10 minutes getting a hold of her and then actually bringing her up some stairs where we could trap her. Then I got a hold of her, took her to the vet, and then that's where they scanned her.
Okay, now you were driving your car going about your life,
yeah.
And you saw a dog and you decided to stop. And then chase and help the dog?
Yeah, because the street is dangerous with a dog. Any dog.
Yeah, I know, but I've seen dogs on the street. I've never stopped and tried to get them and help them and save them.
Yeah, they depend upon us, so we kind of have to help them out a little bit.
Yeah, and you're a big, big supporter of animals.
Yes,
we
have two.
You know the first thing you said to me on the phone? Why didn't your dog have proper Chicago identification tag?
That's right.
Right away, like I was in trouble.
You
know,
I lectured you a little bit.
You gave me a little bit of a lecture, which I kind of liked.
Yeah.
What kind of dogs do you have?
We have two Belgian Malinois.
What are those?
They look like German Shepherds, but they're smaller. Actually, one of the Belgian Malinois, one of the dogs who actually got Osama bin Laden.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's the military dogs and police dogs nowadays.
Excellent, they're big dogs.
The one's a 40-pound one, the other one, a bigger one, is 60 pounds.
And you've been an animal lover your whole life?
Yes.
Yeah, well, we want to thank you because I did not know what would happen with my fiance when I told her, by the way, I have lost your most loved thing in the world. She loves that dog more than anything in the world.
She was adorable because on the way to the vet, she was on my lap looking out the window. You know, and we got to the vet and they scanned her and I asked them, what happens if she doesn't have a tag in her? And they said, well, then we'll call animal cruelty. And I said, well, there's no way I could let her go to county by herself. She's so small.
Right.
So I said, well, I'll just wait for her. And then I found the chip, and then I actually called. And I found the name in Manhattan. I'm thinking, well, somebody stole the dog.
Oh, wow.
You know, I brought it over. I had no idea that...
Yeah, it was Michelle's dog.
Yeah.
And then we moved here. So there you have it.
Exactly.
Well, we didn't know what to do for you, but we knew because you love your dog so much, we thought we would do something for your dogs.
Oh.
All right? So, listen, look at this. Look at the monitor right there. We're sending your dog to the luxurious Pooch Hotel in Chicago. It's the ultimate getaway spot for that special day night anyone. Tasha and Broder will be enjoying a one-night stay at the exclusive presidential suite and swimming sessions at the fitness club and aromatherapy, a spa package complete with pedicures and Poochberry facials. Isn't that fantastic?
That's great.
Yeah, I think they'll like that. And we thought, while you were doing that, we would send you and your wife to the Wynn Hotel so you could have a night to relax at the Doubletree Hilton and have dinner for two at State and Lake, a Chicago Tavern, on us.
Thank you so much for
saving our dog and possibly my pending marriage.
Thank you so much.
Excellent. Tell them to stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
There you go. Thanks.